Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Time to see what's up with these presents over here, and more specifically, a certain mole has his move here, and now we've unlocked pretty much the rest of the world except for one thing. It's the Beak Bomb, and while flying, you press B to slam at these things, and it's actually pretty difficult to use, because you go at crazy speeds, and if you crash into stuff, you'll actually take damage, so it's like a risk-reward type thing. Luckily, I've got everything set up via my health to do this rigmarole, and, well, wish me the best of luck, because this world is still not over even though I've got the move. See, what I gotta do with this Beak Bomb is I've actually gotta destroy all the Cirrus Slushes around here. Oh, poopers. I guess I could grab this Ecum Bokum. There we go. But yeah, there is 5 of them to kill around this area, as well as some other stuff to Beak Bomb. I recommend doing the other stuff first to Beak Bomb, because it's just a little bit less risky, I guess you could say, to get used to this move. So start out with the buttons of the snowman and Beak Bomb those bullseyes. There we go. And go up a little more, and there we go. Oh, I took damage, but somehow I managed to... I don't know how that worked, because I shouldn't take damage when I hit those things. I didn't mean to go... yeah, I needed to kind of do an escape maneuver there. Okay, I gotta loop around back over to the button. Where am I in relation to it? I am here. And Beak Bomb, there we go. That will make a Jiggy appear way down at the bottom. Don't forget about that. I'm not gonna go and grab that just yet because I'm still in flight and whatnot, so... What I'd like to do here is take on those Cirrus Slushes and just get rid of them once and for all, if possible, because they are a pain. So I'm gonna start with you over here. How do you like those apples? Oh, I bounced off your body. Yeah, you gotta hit their hats. Ow! I hate... the Beak Bomb. Well, to an extent. It's a neat move, but it's so risky to do. Poopers. Oh, poopers. Can I make this jump? No, I didn't think so. I always gotta try it, I guess. As something else. Alright, so this flight pad, remember I said that was over here. It's kind of finicky to get up here, though. May take a couple of flap flips. There we go. To actually pull that off, and there's an Ecum Bokum there. I was going to use that pad eventually to get that Ecum Bokum anyway, but, come on, focus, PkGam, do your best to get those, you, stinker, you, this is why this world is so dangerous, yeah, it's because of this particular side quest type jiggy grabbing thing here, and it's just so dang tricky to deal with. Oh! I just flew barely over my my head. I need to loop back around and be bomb out. Uh-oh. That's not good. Oh, I'm at 1 health. That's never a good sign. I need to get myself some delicious honeycomb somewhere. I know that there's some over here. This isn't something that I can do right now. This is for a future side quest. But yeah, I'm glad I know this world so well offhand. So yeah, here's Boggy now. But we'd love to race him, but well, nah, too big for his sled. We can't do it. So we gotta do this race as something smaller. And by something smaller, I mean another transformation. And you know what? Can I reach that over there? I think I can safely. If I go over to... yeah, this edge right here. There's an Ecum Bokum there too. So don't forget your Ecums or your Bokums. Alright, now let's try this again, I guess. Reluctantly, I'm trying it again. Can I really make this jump? Yes, I can. I thought I could. Oh, wait, I need to be in Talon Trot mode. I need to do it in the right timing so I don't get snowballed. And that kind of worked out. Yeah, okay, made it. Let's try it again. I'm gonna just get away from this one because the vertical throws seem to be more dangerous than the horizontal ones, and I'm just gonna weave myself left and right here to try and avoid the shots of doom. By the way, there's an empty honeycomb under one of these Sir Slushes here, so be on the lookout for that. Ah, too low. Dang you and your trickiness. And there's the witch switch, so I'll have to come back for that as well. I'm not going to right now as I'm in flight mode. Get that stinker. No! Wait, there's a flight pad close by here. Might as well get these feathers since I'm burning them. Clearly, this is not my move of choice for flying. I'm in a bad position, I think. Wait, no, this is good. Yes! Okay, Ikum Bokum right under there. Where is the other ones? I got that one over there, yeah? Yeah. Yeah, that one has the last present. Oh boy. So there's one up there, and one over there by the presents. Ah, okay. One more. Let's do it. Focus all of your might on this last Sir Slush. I said all of your might, PkGam, not some of your might. Okay. Can use 100% of it right here, right now. No, not quite. I didn't have the right angle. Oh, this looks good. This looks good right here. Oh, it's so close. I guess I was just using 99%. Oh! You stinker in your squirminess. I don't think I'm ever gonna finish this world. Not anytime soon. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, I'll get it, though. I'll get it. Alright, wipe the sweat off my forehead, and I'm ready to shoot once again. Beak Bomb! Yes! There is the empty honeycomb. And destroying all those makes a Jiggy appear way up there. I don't know if I have enough feathers to actually get up there, though. Well, at least not without using the flight pad over at ye ol' snowman nose. So what I'm gonna do here is show a little bit of this road. Wait, no, not this road. It is back this way, yes. Needless to say, okay, let's try this jump again. But anyway, needless to say, I'm saving those notes in the water for later because not safe, but our transformation will be able to take care of that. Alright, let's get the third present, though. Very carefully, so without touching the water. Voila! By the way, the order that you've seen the dialogue that I got the presents at will be the same, no matter which order you get the presents in, so you didn't miss any dialogue there, no matter what. Okay. Now that I got all the presents, I am going to go all the way up here again, because there's the Jiggy up top. And then I'd like to fly back over to the kids, because that's just a little bit faster in general, too. And then I'll be back down the bottom for the Jiggies and the Witch Switch and the other stuff at the bottom floor. And then I'll eventually hit a transformation point. You don't have to leave the world as a transformation this time, so don't worry about that. Okay. Now, flight pad over here, because I was low on feathers, so I had to kind of go do the rigmarole. Alright, I need to get up here, like so. Voila! Yeah, there's no other way to get up here other than using the flight pad, and that's a big one. And there's our Jiggy. Yeah! Now, it may seem like we're making a slow pace here, but we've actually got pretty much most of the world done here. It's just a matter of going back to the different locations to actually do the things that we need to do. Like, there's the Jiggy, right below the snowman right here. There are the kids that I got the presents for, which are back near the starts, which I gotta go flop over there now. There is a little transformation type thing which will lead to basically the rest of it. whoa, careful. Alright, so as I was saying, I'm gonna fly over to the kids because it's just easier to do that, and I'm gonna beak bomb just because I'm feeling excited. And I guess I can safely slam there and go in. Alright, let's see the dialogue one at a time carefully. Hopefully, maybe. Okay, one at a time, please. There we go. You're welcome! Okay, another bit of dialogue. Woohoo! Aw, yeah! We're almost there. Notice that they match their colors, too, by the way. The presents and, you know, wrapping paper. Woo! Everything! And thus, the prize is, of course, a Jiggy. Who would have guessed it's a Jiggy? Oh yeah, got 5 out of 10. Well, we're only going to be able to get 9 this run through, because as I said, we need those special shoes to get the last one, but it's not a big deal, just as long as I get all the notes and whatnot. Normally in my playthroughs off camera, what I would do is I would go over to the 6th world just for that move, and then I would come back over to here and leave the 6th world for later, but I thought, I'll just go over to here for now, because it's just leading the whole Grunty's world, in order and stuff like that, just makes everything kind of meld together in a certain nice way. Okay, here's a nice way to get to the center. It's actually rather tricky to get to the center if you don't know a certain specific spots. That was a tongue twister. To actually get to the center area underneath the snowman. So there is the Jiggy that I got for beak bombing its buttons. Remember beak bombing its buttons in the last part? That's what I get it for. And I really should be talent trotting this whole way through, because Banjo's feet just do not grip whatsoever. And there's another way to get over there relatively easily, is that box right there. But I think I can reach this from here without taking damage, yes. This is going to unlock something a little bit up there. Yeah, remember that? That's why I said that I couldn't do that earlier, because there is something to do over there. Well, now I can do that something. Let's see here. I'd want to show a little bit of dialogue over on this side before I do my transformation. So, that means I can now go and collect the notes over by this box, if I recall. Yes, there are some notes there, indeed. And Ecom Bokum it up. Oh no! What? It is? What? What? Shouldn't there be another dialogue here? Oh, there we go. There's the dialogue that should have been happening before that nasty fierce bear came through here. But I'm not dangerous. I'm fluffy and huggable. Look at me. Look at me. I'm love. Just. Oh, fine. I can't do anything about him for now. Sadness. Sadness. Oh, don't miss the notes. There we go. No, I'm just kidding. I can't do anything for realsies. I've got to be in my transformed state in order to do anything about that. So let's do that now. I got to go all the way around to get myself into... Wait, well, how's my health? Okay, my health is good. I just seen the beehive over there and I thought, let's refill if I need to. But no, I'm making pretty good progress health-wise and whatnot, so yeah. There is the race that I've got to do a little bit later on. And there's Mumbo's place. Now, what you're normally supposed to do is fly over there, but I'm impatient, so I'm gonna take one honeycomb of damage. It should be obvious that you need to fly there, but the way to back is, of course, the boots there. Oh, and there's an extra life on top of his house. I guess I'll show that too, because why not? So let's flap flip up there. Oh, come on, flap flip. That, I know that's how you get up there. I've done this before. Don't tell me otherwise. Don't you dare. I did this over at Mumbo's Mountain. There we go. Oops. Oh, that is incredibly unfortunate. This is not worth it. But yet, I still want to show you how to get it. obviously the easier way is to fly up there, but this is definitely possible this way. Right on the edge? Yes! Alright. I like how frosty his hut looks here. I think that looks pretty cool. Oh, yes. And we are well ahead of the mumble token curve here, so you don't have to worry about that in the slightest. Go over here and get ourselves a Jinjo. Heck yeah! And the last 10 notes are... the last couple of notes are in the water over by, you know, where we've seen the water and whatnot. But for now, let's do our transformation! We are a walrus! Happy days! And now with the power of a walrus, which actually has no attacks whatsoever. So it's definitely a good idea to take care of those sewer slushes so that you have a decent way to get around here safely. You can now go through the cold water, of course, because, well, you're a walrus. And here are the last notes that I was talking about. Right over here. I thought there was 10 here, but maybe I accidentally collected one? I don't know, but I could have swore these were the last notes. Yeah, these are the last notes. Yeah, maybe I collected one around at the corner or something like that. But now I can die freely! Yes! Yes! All my notes! Oh wait, actually no, I can't die freely yet. There's still the issue of the Jinjos and whatnot, but I'm not gonna die anytime soon on this now that I'm a walrus, because all the dangers are pretty much taken care of. So yeah, now that I'm a walrus, I can actually do this race now. All I gotta do is get on! This is the most difficult jump in the game, clearly. There we go! All you gotta do is go through the red gates, and they'll change red as we go. Ready? This is actually a pretty tricky game, so prepare yourself. Well, maybe not this particular portion, but something else is. And yes, you can jump, so keep that in mind, as it's helpful. Alright, try and stay ahead, try and take the corners as tightly as possible, if at all possible. And also, try not to do your turns too wide. So I'm gonna try and take them on the inside of the holes. And yes, you can actually- oh, shoot! Oh, that was close. Thought I missed one there for a second. Yeah, you can actually touch them and make them wobble, which is pretty neat. Oh, he always seems to get ahead here for some reason, but then he lets you get back ahead at the end. This is what I mean to remember to jump! Yep, gotta jump, gotta jump, 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 gotta go, go, go! And we are making good time here. Oh boy, okay. This is looking good. Looking very good, in fact. Oh, that's not good. I was gonna say, oh no. Well, at least I didn't miss that bit of dialogue. That's okay, though. But I'll have enough time to catch up, because as I said, he lets you get ahead near the end. I think it's because he doesn't go up the slope very easily. And these are all slopes near the end here by the finish line. Remember I got the honeycombs over here? And then we go grab our gold at the Olympics podium. It really does look like the Olympics podium based on the... yeah. See that? Only it's blue, green, and red instead of gold, silver, and bronze. Yeah. Alright, now that I'm a walrus, I can get the last two jiggies here. Wow, another walrus! Take this! But watch out for Smelly Brown Bear and his ugly bird partner. Oh no, not the Smelly Brown Bear. Woo! Now, I need to transform back in order to finish this world, but I'm just gonna show you right here what I need to do before I go back over to Mumbo. So yeah, as you can tell, there's a Jinjo up there that I cannot get. But that is unfortunate. However, there is something else that I can get here, though. Not these feathers, though. Can you say, final empty honeycomb? I can say that, and I just did. Yeah, underneath the water here, which you obviously can't go through as Banjo because you'll die from hypothermia, is here that you can get with the walrus easy. Woo! And look out for our ice cube friend, because, as I said, you don't have attacks, so he is effectively invincible to you. What else do we got here in terms of prizes? There's a 1-up. I'm more interested in the eggs and feathers more than anything, though, in all honesty. Alright, so that's nice and cleared out. So now all I have to do is go back over to Mumbo, transform back, come back in this cave, because now the walrus is no longer scared and blocking this cave. And then I'll be able to hop up there with a flap flip jump and get the last Jinjo. And that'll finish off this world.
Woohoo!
Boy, that was quick! Look at that! Oh no! Not the bear! Anything but the bear! Or noisy orange thing. Alright, so here is the Jiggy for the last Jinjo! Oh yeah, and if you take a look at something in the background there, look at that mysterious ice key back there. Is there a way to get that? Maybe. Maybe. But for now, I'm gonna leave it. I'm going to go around this way, and remember that I said we couldn't get everything in this world? Yet? Well, it's time to show you just why that is. And wait a second. I need to go... where is... I'm so turned around. I need to go all the way around to Boggy once again. Remember the racer Boggy the Bear? And that is all the way up this slope, which is probably harder to get to from the other side. And I'm just going to show you this right here. Hey, buddy! Fancy a race against Boggy? So yeah, he wants to battle someone of his own size this time, as he said. So, here we go. Look at that, there's the running shoes. And, without them, this is absolutely impossible, and I would like to show you that. But it's very easy to come back here anyway, you know, even if you leave this for later, because it's pretty quick and whatnot to actually just go down the slope and then come back up the slope, yeah. Oh no, he's getting so far ahead that he's gonna give up the race because it's just too easy to beat me. So yeah, alas, victory is not meant to be right now until I get the shoes. So, unfortunately, I'm gonna have to leave this world by pressing B. Well, not literally leave the world by pressing B. I mean by pressing B by leaving his dialogue. And then actually leaving the world because, well, that's all I can do in this world for now. So I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you in the next part, baby! Yeah!